Morning, peoples. Right, where are we today? Saturday the 15th of December. First thing you will have noticed is that I'm not in my truck. And that is because I'm not working for my current employers. Helping a friend out this week, doing some fridge work. On my way down to Italy with Seven Drops, I think I've got Turin, Fiera Milan, Fidenza, Bologna, and Bergamo. So, yeah, just leaving the UK, and we're on the train today, and that's why I thought I'd start the filming here. You'll have to excuse me, because I'm absolutely full of cold. So I'm hoping you can hear me alright, because I've had no end of problems with bloody GoPro cases. The one that I normally use, I broke. And I did a trip down to Barcelona and filmed that, and then realised that you couldn't hear anything because the case that I was using was the waterproof case with the backing on it, and you just couldn't hear anything. So hopefully you'll be able to hear me a little bit better. So I did film some stuff on the way back from Barcelona, and I've not checked it over yet to see what it looks like or what it sounds like. So if I don't post that, the reason why I've not posted anything else is because after I finished the tour, which was the last thing that I videoed, I accidentally deleted the footage, because I'm clever like that. So I'm going to invest in a new case for the GoPro, a proper skeleton case, after Christmas, because I've got some good stuff coming up next year, some stuff that I'd definitely like to video. But for now, I'm kind of just making do with what I've got. But I really wanted to film this, because it's not very often that I come on the train anymore. We tend to use the boat, whereas the guys that I'm working for use the train. And it's really tight getting on, really, really tight. And people will tell you it's not. I don't really care what people say, to be honest. In my opinion, it's tight. So I'll get on the train, and then I think once I get off, I'll explain in a little bit more detail how this works, because this is a completely different system to the ferry. as you can see, there's not a lot of room at all. I don't think you ever realise how hard it is to drive in a straight line until you have to drive in a straight line. I mean, I'm sure they could have made this a few inches wider. Right, so I'm going to go get some fuel, fill my tanks up, and then press on down towards Italy. I think I've done about 2.5 hours driving this morning, so get another good 1 o'clock local, so we're not pushed for time. Start my tips Monday morning, so I don't have to go bananas. We'll get a good shift on today. That should put us hopefully about 300 miles away, which will leave me about 6 or 7 hours to do tomorrow. think we're going to go and get some fuel a bit further down the road, because I just can't be bothered with the hassle going in there. So it seems as though the French are not quite over their protests yet, because I can only imagine that's what we're queuing for here. They've been causing all kinds of trouble. Protests about, I think it was to do with fuel prices, and then they started protesting about wages. And when the French protest, they don't do it by halves. So yeah, anyway, about the train, completely different system to the boat. What actually happens on the train is you put your truck on the train, similar process, booking in, you go through all the booking in process, you drive onto the train, you get out your truck, you're not allowed to stay in your truck, you get out the truck, and a minibus will come and pick you up, and it's a horrific experience, or it can be. You basically get picked up by a minibus, the minibus will drive up and down the train, picking up all the drivers from each truck, stops at each carriage, picks up the drivers from the trucks. So you get, like I said, you get on the minibus with all the other drivers, and then the minibus will take you to the carriage of the train, the passenger carriage, because there's only one passenger carriage, and there's two minibuses, because as you can imagine, with all the trucks on the train, it's bloody long. So you get two minibuses, one serves the front and one serves the back. And if you get on the back of the train, you get on the back of the carriage. And what you need to remember is, when you get off, to get on the same bus. Normally they'll put a they'll hold up a board with your number bus. So for example, I was number 2, and then when you get off the train, the two minibuses are there waiting, and they'll hold out the board for whichever bus, obviously, you're going on. But sounds confusing, I know, but it's not unknown for people to get on the wrong bus, and if you do that, then you're not going to be flavour of the month, let's put it that way, because it's a long train. And if everybody's waiting to get off, and you're at the front of the train and you need to be at the back and your truck's in the way, like I said, you're not going to be flavour of the month. I don't know what's going on here. Lane to go in. Did we have to try and sneak up the inside, or let's go and have a look.
This is just crazy. This is absolutely crazy. Complete carnage. But the French don't care. This is how they get the point across. I don't know what he's doing. I don't think he knows what he's doing either. So we're going to go see if we can get a parking space in here, which is going to be fun, because this services, as you can see, serves both sides of the road. I've just come off the southbound side, and there's a little unlit, well, I say unlit, there's a little parking area over there, but the main service area is serving the northbound side. So you can actually get onto the northbound side from the southbound side now. Therefore, it's going to be twice as busy, especially with it being Saturday night. Oh, look at that, straight in. Yeah, it's Saturday night and most people can't drive tomorrow. General haulage, lads. Now, how has he got in there? I wouldn't mind parking out the way, really, if I can, because I've got a fridge on, and if it kicks in during the night, I don't want to be waking people up. It's just trying to have a bit of consideration, really. It's 3 degrees outside at the minute, and I think since I picked this load up yesterday, the fridge is set to 0 degrees, and I think since I picked it up yesterday, I've heard it kick in twice. And that's mainly down to the fact that it holds its temperature really well when it's like this outside. So all being well, I shouldn't hear it tonight. Well, it's not me, it's the people around me. Gonna go and have a little look around, I think, and see if I can find somewhere out the way of everybody else to park. There's nowhere else to park, so I'm gonna end my shift. And yeah, as I was saying before, these lads will be parked for the day tomorrow because you're not allowed to run in France on a Sunday unless you're carrying perishable goods or livestock and other exceptions, or if you've got a permit. But usually it tends to be really busy on a Saturday night because everyone's trying to get parked up for the weekend. So I was quite surprised actually to find a couple of open bays like that. But yeah, it's really cold outside, so hopefully the fridge won't be running during the night, because like I said, it holds its temperature really well. And not that it bothers me obviously, but like I said, just having some consideration for other people really. But we should be all right. So I'm going to get something to eat and a shower, I think, and continue in the morning. Morning. So it's 8:20 local, now Sunday the 16th. And about ready to go, just done my checks, had my coffee, 375 miles to my destination. Right, the fridge held its temperature all night last night. I think I heard it come on at about 11 o'clock just before I went to bed, and I've not heard it since. That's not to say it didn't come on, obviously. But if it did, I didn't hear it. So another full day's drive, well, probably 7.5-8 hours, and I'll be near to my first drop, which is just north of Turin. I don't know how much I'm going to get filmed because the GoPro batteries are playing up for some reason. They're just not charging. So I might be able to put something together, I might not. But I'm glad the roads are clear this morning because it was really trying to snow last night actually when I went for my tea. Excuse the sniffing, like I said, I'm really full of cold. Yeah, so I don't know what it's going to be like down by the Alps. It may well be a whiteout. But no doubt we'll find out soon enough. So I'm just going to go in here and get some fuel. While I'm here, I'm going to take this opportunity to give you a quick look at what I'm driving. So there she is in all her glory. Volvo. 540 horses. All the alloy wheels and that. It's good to have a quick check of the fridge. Yeah, it's a nice truck. Drives really nice. Last time I came down here I was in a 750, so it would be unfair of me to form an opinion based on driving the 750, which is just in a league of its own really. But yeah, really smart, and like I said, it drives really nice. Might do a bit of a review at some point. Here's something I'll just quickly point out. I really like fueling in France, because once you've put your card in to get your fuel, you have your card machine here. Once you've put your card in to get your fuel the big tank first with this pump here. Once you've done, just press that button, go around the other side and get the nozzle out the other side, and you don't have to put your card back in and fanny around putting all your details in and everything again. So really handy. So yeah, we're up in the Alps now, or down in the Alps, however. Down if you're speaking geographically, or up in terms of elevation. But yeah, this is really, really nice around here in summer. Really, really nice, as you might be able to see. Mountains. Snow on top of the mountains. Yeah. We're about 50 kilometers now from the Frejus tunnel, so just going to take a quick picture for the boss because he likes his pictures, and then crack on to Italy. Right, that's the fuel and AdBlue sorted. Both full to the brim, so ...89 miles now to the destination, so I'll probably be parking up in about an hour and a half, because I'm not going to go quite all the way. So yeah, I'm using the Frejus tunnel today because my first drop is, as I've said, Turin. If you're doing Northern Italy or Milan, then you'd normally use the Mont Blanc tunnel, which is slightly further north from where we are now. And I will more than likely be using the Mont Blanc tunnel on the way back, so I'll probably do a bit there as well, because you have to stop before you get to the tunnel when you use the Mont Blanc and get a ticket. The Frejus, you just run straight up to the tunnel and straight through, but the Mont Blanc is slightly different. You, like I said, you get your ticket, and when you've got a fridge like I have, you have to have an escort through the tunnel as well. So probably do that on the way back. But yeah, let's press on, get down into Italy and get parked up. And that is the Frejus tunnel done, and this is Italy, and I'm just going to stop here and get the obligatory photo.
Plenty of snow on the ground up here.
It's
to Italy, guys. This is just absolutely stunning with this snow on the ground like this. Really, really pretty. So what we're on, 3:45 local, and I'm 56 miles, which is 90 k's from my destination, which I should be able to do in an hour. Like I said, I'm not going to go all the way, probably going to stop about 20 miles short, so yeah, we parked up nice and early and get 11 hours off again tonight as well. Which means I will have used only 11 hour breaks and 13 hour days on the way down. So that leaves me all my 9s and 15s to get my drops off and collections and get back. So yeah, we're looking good. Just look at the scenery up here, it's absolutely stunning. This is incredible. First one was nothing short of an absolute nightmare. 5 o'clock I turned up there, it's now 8:15 local. Nobody seemed to know what was going on or what was going where, and it turns out the paperwork was in the wrong order. So not my fault, but hey ho. So yeah, I just thought I'd record this bit because if you're into your football, on the right hand side there, that is Juventus's ground. So, running late, but off to our second drop. Right, this is looking good because I can see loads of fridges down here. So we're in the right area. I'm just hoping all these guys aren't waiting because I have literally got one pallet to come off here. So the last thing I need to be doing is queuing with these lot. Couldn't make this up, could you? Fuck's sake. Right, number two done. In and out in 5 minutes, if that. Took me longer to get on the bay than it did to get tipped in there. Couldn't have made that one any tighter. Numero tres. Oh, I'm just going to sling it here a minute while I go find out what the deal is. Number three complete. A bit of a weird place to have deliver to, but there you go. So apparently the next one is an hour and 43 minutes away. Now it's only 54 miles, but it's telling me it's going to take me an hour and 43 minutes. And I've got an hour and 26 minutes driving left before I need a 30 minute break. So am I going to make that time up somewhere or not? Shall find out. So no, I didn't make it. That is a typical example of why you could do with an extra 5 minutes here and there. So a mile and a quarter away, and I had 3 minutes driving time left. So I must have made up a good 17, 18 minutes on the way, but I just couldn't risk it, because it's probably going to take me 2 minutes to back on the bay. I've been to this one before, and I just couldn't risk it. So unfortunately we had to stop and have 30 minutes. Yeah, a mile, all over a mile. How annoying. Anyway, I'm probably going to make this video in two parts, because I've done about an hour's worth of filming already, and I'm just not going to put a 2 hour vlog together. I'm not even halfway through. I'm just on my fourth drop now of seven, and I've probably got collections as well. So I'm not going to, like I said, I'm not going to put a 2 hour video together. It's just going to drag on way too much. So I'll probably do it in two parts. Just hope there's nothing coming around this corner. Oh bugger, there's someone on the bay. So this is where I need to be, just there on the left hand side. Yeah, right, I'm going to call it a day there as well with this video, because, like I said, it's getting too long now, so... Again, if you've watched it this far, thank you very much. See you in another part.